breaking the wall of Judgment Day. This is a cartoon from a Danish newspaper 10 years ago. It shows a Danish bishop with a warning sign telling that the end is near. The bishop is me, and the church is the Dome of Maribo. A journalist had asked me if the climate change could indicate that the end of the world is near. My answer was very cautious. I don't know, but maybe, I said. Christians expect Jesus to come again, so why not? The end might be near when Jesus will come to judge the living and the dead. This started a tough debate in many newspapers. How could a bishop talk about and believe in this? The walls of the churches were somehow broken. People outside the church heard what they didn't know, that Christians believe someday the world will come to an end and there will be a judgment day for all human beings. Now I'll break down another wall for you. Did you know that Muslims also believe that Jesus will come again? And someday the world will come to an end and there will be a judgment day for all human beings. 14 days ago, I visited a mosque in Aarhus. As you can see, we were sitting talking about the judgment day. Islam teaches that in the afterlife, on the day of judgment, all people will be just. Faith and good deeds done during one's lifetime will be rewarded with paradise, and bad deeds and corruption by worldly temptations will be punished with hell, the place of no hope and full of suffering. What are the differences between Islam and Christianity? It is important to be honest and fair and aware of this question. And that is my theological project. I want to compare and analyze what Christians and Muslims, what Christianity and Islam actually teach and believe. Is the judgment day a day of fear or hope? In the New Testament, Jesus is called the dawn from heaven. We have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us and for the whole world in Jesus Christ. Therefore, we may have hope and confidence on the day of judgment. The dawn from heaven is what I, as a Christian, want Muslims to see and to know about. You might call it my mission.